probably aren't. Because things are complicated. And I hate to be a downer, but it seems like that might be the case. Just gotta see what my stream's looking like right now. It is looking rough at the moment. It's not too bad though. It's better than it was. Okay. We're gonna roll with it, see what's good. And yeah, let me put some more music back on. I'm gonna put a different playlist on. This playlist kind of booty ass. What's the one I used to do? The hip hop one? I thought it was this chill playlist, but these aren't these are definitely not the same songs that used to play in my streams. I think my stuff's better now. I think it's a little better. I'm really talking to myself at this point, because ultimately y'all are the ones who decide that. But I'm going to put this hip hop playlist on. Okay. Though, what is oh my god, dude, what is this, brother? I need beats, I need instrumental music. What is this? I can't listen to Dax yelling in my ear, bro. We're playing the Minecraft inspired playlist, bro. This is where we need to be. Lo-fi nice guy. Bet. Shit like this makes the creative process so much more difficult for at least me, because I cannot concentrate and I have to like re I have to like re identify what I'm doing, as well as find a way to to entertain people, because I'm not usually talking when I'm when I'm drawing. At least I haven't been the last few months. Thank you, Stream Elements, for saying that in my chat. I appreciate you. Thank you. Thank you for letting my lovely fans know. WTF about to go down, brother. Stream is still a little fucked up. I apologize for the poor stream quality, guys. It's really a fat L. Bro, this is not a Minecraft inspired playlist. I'm listening to Pop Smoke right now. What is this? Let's keep it rolling, dude. Man, I really don't know what's wrong with the stream. That really sucks, man. I mean, at least it's better than it was, but it's not good. Alright, well, I'm gonna... start drawing all these blades of grass sticking out of the water. I think when it exports the VOD, everything will be very clean, and so I shouldn't have to worry. And I really hope I don't have to worry. Yeah, it's just really, really annoying. Now we're gonna draw the grass that's behind here. First, let me fix this grass though, because this is... I'm just gonna use this lasso tool to select that portion. Create that water line, which... Wait. No, we do... Need to edit this line here. Add this somewhere like here. And so we can delete that, and then this grass all goes behind this line. Lower that a little for a second. noticed that a lot of these straight lines that I draw, they end up getting really kind of like finicky. I think I'm gonna replace the tip on the end of my pen here. If I can find the bag. Another thing about digital drawing is when you use these pens. I have a Wacom tablet and pen. You have to get new tips often because you actually burn the tip down. You like shave it down as you draw. And sometimes it makes the lines come out a little less clear. As you can see, that's a little straighter than what I just was drawing. And it makes it easier to draw because they kind of glide more on the tablet. Draw some weird little plants here. Draw that later. So what I think I'm going to do here, now that things are kind of getting a little messy, there are a few things I can do. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to hide this layer for now. And we're going to start with this midground and sort of start putting these details down, because I might even kind of color in these layers so they kind of overlap each other and I know... which lines belong where, because I don't want to erase anything. I kind of just want to cover them up for now. So I think I'm going to do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this all in one layer. So the log is all one thing. It's not all one layer. Sorry. I'm putting it in a folder together and then I'm hiding the folder. And then now I can draw the details on here. So I'm gonna make a new layer, call it details. So I'm just drawing a little lichen on this rock here. Now, a little different from the moss, because the moss is kind of like thicker. Lichen is kind of just like a thin layer of algae or whatever. Whoops. So I probably won't make it like kind of protrude over this rock. I kind of just leave it like that. But we'll see. Maybe I'll make it protrude a little bit. But I'll definitely add like a little, couple little pieces here and there, kind of, just like the moss, just kind of building away from the bigger pieces. Something like that. I feel like that looks pretty good. Okay, I'm gonna actually name this lichen. And then I'm gonna, I guess, just name this Slayer mushrooms. Maybe that one didn't bloom fully yet, you know? Add a little depth to what I'm doing. Baby mushrooms. Whoops. Something like that. I think that looks pretty good. Okay, so this one has a big old kind of root sticking out of it. This one's like dirt, not really rock. So it kind of helps to give this one a little more of a natural shape, almost kind of. Not like equal width around. I think I need to make this part a little thicker though, right here. Something like that, maybe that overlaps a little. Good, mess around, draw this arrow right away. dude. So a lot of times when I draw, like, arrows, I like to kind of overlap a little with a little bit of wrap. Some kind of thing, but it's like a very subtle. Here, we'll do it like this. Very subtle kind of thing tied around it. Little rip part. Just a little more 3D, a little more depth to it. Man. See, right here, there's a lot of roots, like, coming around and kind of making things messy here. That might need to be revised a little bit, but we're gonna get it. Something like this. We're gonna add a big root on this one too. Something like this. Okay, now I'm gonna look up some references for the fungi kind of thing I'm doing. Just gonna look up Swamp Scene. See what I can find. Maybe swamp fungus. I don't think you guys can see my screen right now, but. Thank you. Alright, here. Alright, this is what I'm planning on sort of making. This shit. Look at this shit. I don't know if this is exactly what I was going for, but something like this. And for those of you who have trypophobia, I feel for you, because I also have that. But you gotta do what you gotta do. This kind of thing doesn't kind of trigger that as much as like a finger with like holes in it, like a fake like image of a finger with holes. That shit's disgusting. But something's interesting about this one. This one's more interesting than disgusting. This shit just looks like SpongeBob. So, I'm thinking we do something like this. Add a little third dimension to it. Follow my sketch a little more. Now what I'm doing is going to get a little complicated, because I'm making this pretty 3D looking, and it's a really strange shape to begin with. Let's see, let's come back to that little part. Thank you. Do something like that, I think. That looks pretty good. Although, should probably tuck this in a little more. Puffed out. Fix this. It's more like that. Yeah, it looks better. So anyway, I think that looks pretty decent. Still gotta add a little more of the edges like this. Realistically, I should kinda draw these kinda going more to the left over this. So I'm gonna do that. something like that. Man, some of these beats are like clipping, dude. I'm not into that, bro. I'm gonna have to make some fucking food soon, dude. Kinda hungry, dude. It's already 4:12, dude. Only ate breakfast, dude. That looks pretty good. This will be another kind of weird fungus thing. I don't know why I called it vines. Worry about that in a little bit. Alright, let's label this reference. Let's label this fungus 2. Let's hide the reference right now. Alright, I'm gonna add some lines to this this root here. Just kinda emphasize the sort of direction that these lines are pointing. Kind of extend them. So they kind of like twist and follow a path. Something like that. I feel like that looks pretty good. I'm gonna actually edit this one a little bit. kind of want the bottom to be a little more spread out, kind of have more ridges. Something like that. Just gotta add some more lines here. Like I said, just follow the kind of the route that it's going. Looks alright. Gonna fix that a little bit. Okay, those look pretty good. Let's do this one now. For the bigger ones, I'm gonna add details too. Just cause, I don't know. Definitely making some progress. But man, it's getting confusing around this point. I'm gonna start doing the foreground details. So it's gonna be all of this kind of grass poking out of the water. Rocks here and these weird plants. That's good. So then let's see. Good. Oops. Actually, there's a lot to draw here. That's pretty good. Okay, let's fix this. Bro, that's gotta be like the Sonic the Hedgehog spin dash sound. There's no way. It's gotta be that, bro. All right. This is pretty good. Let me get Let me draw a couple of these little Pac-Mans here. Okay, a fucking lily pad. I don't know if the mic took pick that up, but my neck just cracked so hard, bro. Holy shit. Ugh. That's what sitting in a chair for 3.5 hours will do to you. Oh, God. So what we still need to do in this foreground is these two arrows, both of these skeletons, and all these weird tentacle plants, is what I'm going to call them. So I'm going to name this layer tentacle plants, because I think that's funny. And they look like tentacles. Honestly, these are easier to draw than the grass, I think, because this shape that I'm making is a lot easier than, like, making it almost, like, parallel. Except I just did it pretty good right there, but nevertheless, I need to fix this one. Look how ugly this looks, bro. Do you see my issue? That's all of those, and now I gotta draw kind of like the base of it. A details layer for all the little like spores or whatever. I should have those visible so I can at least tell exactly where I'm placing these on it. I just didn't want the lines to kind of confuse me, but I think we'll be all right. Thank you. And I might add more details to these things too. More detail to these things. For right now, I'm just gonna make circles though. Let's do these arrows. I think we're gonna do arrows and then arrow details. That way I can sort of add this in front of this layer. Little feather here. And I can add they're kinda in the back like that. Then I add kind of a little overlap here. And then I can add a little wrap around it. Okay, so we got some arrows, we got these rocks, we got these fucking tentacle things. We just gotta get the skeletons, which I think I'm gonna do towards the end more. Oh man. I mean, we're definitely making progress. You got that 50 bucks? This is what I think I'm gonna do. I think I'm gonna make sort of like a to-do list and kind of sketch it out real quick. This is what I tend to do a lot when I'm making stuff and I don't want to forget where I am. I'm just gonna do like watermelons, skeletons. Just kind of sketch these tree details quick. Obviously, the new Machi here. Just real quick, real quick. just draw some bush lines real quick, some detail. I'll draw a couple more bushes right here, actually. Now I'm gonna, everything that we've drawn today, I'm gonna put it in one layer and just call this ink for now. And now we can look at all the stuff that we still have to draw. So we still have to draw all this. Obviously it's not gonna show everything, so I circled the skeletons here. But if we take everything away, this is what we've drawn today. So this is pretty, this is a lot. You know, a couple hours. My hands are certainly sore at the moment. So I think we're gonna, let's make this foreground. I had the foreground for now because I don't want to worry about that right now. We're gonna hide the mid ground for now because I don't really want to worry about that right now. And I'm gonna put this to do layer under the ink layer, the ink folder here. Although I accidentally put it inside of it. I'm gonna label this to do. Control save as always, folks. Now I'm just gonna see what I should do next. Let's even go as far as to hide BG rocks for now. Get those out of the way. So as you can see, I kind of continued this line in that quick to-do sketch here. So I think what I'm gonna do right away is kind of continue the ink of it. Way past here. I'm gonna redraw that. Kind of want it to look a little more like a hill there. Did I draw this on the wrong layer? I did. That's okay, because we're gonna lasso it, control X to cut it, click on this once again, okay, control shift V to place it back where it was. This is the horizon, so then we're gonna merge down. Okay. Rotate that. So now off the to-do, we can kind of erase this line because we drew it now. I'm honestly just going to erase this too because we'll get to that eventually. And I have a better sketch of it, so we'll finish this, sort of a tree sketch. Maybe even refine it a little bit. Why not? Okay, now this is the layer with the bushes and stuff, so I'm going to draw this bush on this layer. Okay. Okay, so all these bushes and stuff, I'm gonna make on a different layer than the one that it's on. And I'll make it like a far background thing. So Control X to cut, Control Shift V to place it back in the same spot. Far BG bushes. So then on this layer, I'll draw these bushes. Whoops. I'm gonna do this tree quick. And remember, this is on a this is on a different layer now, so it's not gonna mess with anything. I'm just gonna go ahead and draw these trees right away. Oops. I don't know if you guys can hear the ambulance outside my house. I live on a busy street. Shit gets real. Where the fuck? Oh my god. There, that only took me 30 times. Alright, let's do these trees. That was pretty good. First try. Whoops. Is this on the same layer? Yeah, so I'm gonna just block that off here. We'll even do something like, whoops. Okay. Hell yeah, brother. Yeah. So anyway, as you see, I'm going back to my to-do layer, deleting everything I just drew from the to-do layer, but keeping the new version. I'm just gonna erase this. I don't think I need that. I'll draw that one. and then I'll just draw a new one. Nope. It's wild, bro. I guess I'm playing like a Monster Cat playlist right now. That's crazy. That shit's crazy. That shit's crazy, bro. We listening to Skrillex right now. Alright, where we at? Is this all the same? Yeah. Okay, so now we're gonna do... I'm just gonna make this layer called Bark. Yo, this is literally a Minecraft beat. Samples Minecraft. That's crazy. As an artist, you can see I'm kind of boring because I use the same width brush for everything. Kind of just like, the further the details back are, the less the less details there are. Sometimes I make them a little narrower if I really feel like I need to. Kind of depends on the whatever art I'm making. This has to be Minecraft music too, right? Fucking violin's going crazy, bro. Yo. I'm here for the fucking violin, brother. Sheesh. Whoops. I think that's pretty good. Let's go back to the to-do and erase all that. Okay. Let's go back to this. Well, you know what? I'm gonna erase these first, and then now we're gonna go to the bush layer. I guess I'm gonna make a bush detail layer, even though probably don't need to, but kind of just add some puffs along here. that up real quick. Go back to this layer. I'm just gonna add those. Oh shit, I forgot to add a whoopsie. Looking good. Alright, let's go to this far BG bushes. I'm not gonna make a separate layer for that because there's just a few of them. We'll just do some real quick. Whoops. Okay, solid. Okay, we're looking a lot better now. Alright, so I'm thinking we should do this. Let's do this tree here. Alright, brother, that's a fucking tree. That's a tree, brother. That's a tree. Let's go, baby. That's a tree. Let's go. I think I'm gonna hide the to-do layer for now. We're gonna call this the BG or background. I mean, we're looking good. We went crazy so far. There's a lot of stuff we're looking at right now. Alright, I think we're gonna remove the background, the midground, and the foreground, and just look at the background rocks, which I guess are technically probably in the background, but or midground. Then we can do these. We're gonna have to really fix that water line, which it's still kind of messed up. Alright, what is. Okay. Details. Something like that. A couple little mushrooms, you know. do a nice girthy one there. Nah, we won't do a girthy one. We'll just do that. Beautiful. Thinking, what if we do like a, we'll just do, call it a fog, something like that. I think in terms of this layer, I think we're good. So we just got to go back to the to-do, erase all this. Let's make a layer behind this for these few things. So this, I believe this is just grass. So honestly, let's just do it like this. Just erase this because this doesn't look good overlapping that. I'm just gonna gonna erase this, or do a little something with that later, I'm sure. I might, you know, still add to the to-do layer, or just do it on the spot if I feel like I should. Like, for instance, this tree should definitely tuck behind this layer. And this should definitely go past here. Almost drew on the wrong layer there. Forgive me. Just gotta make sure these are both the same, yeah. So I fixed that up. Okay, so I'm just gonna make this go all the way through. Be less confused. So I'm gonna add a little detail layer to this tree as well, because it needs some bark on it. Yeah, like I said, this water line needs some work, but in terms of where it's at right here is fine. So maybe I just gotta... Whoops. It's even fine right there too. It's just... Oh my gosh. What is going on? Control D to deselect, thank you. Just gotta make sure. Oh, let's cut it there. Honestly, we could just go ahead and cut it there too. Alright, I'm gonna put the sketch layer back up now. And then I'm gonna get rid of this to-do layer, because now we're going to sketch both of these skeletons. But I'm gonna hide the whole ink layer for this. Now, I love drawing skeletons and all, but there's no promises on how long it's going to take me to do this. Because I do mess up a lot when drawing characters and skeletons and stuff. Pretty good though. Might move the eye a little to the left, like just barely. I feel like that might look a little better. Start with this arm here, since it's kind of in front of the rest of the body. Yo, you bumping that Minecraft music, brother? Oh, we're taking Minecraft to the trap, boy. Oh shit. This reminds me of Them Changes by Thundercat. Lucky, holding you back, holding you down. It does not look too bad. I think I should, however, make this a little tighter. Looks pretty good. Alright, I'm gonna draw these arrows behind the skeleton. That smoked them. The arrows that smoked the skeleton. So he's got. Let's do it like this. Down a little bit. Just to make it a little cleaner. Just gotta follow that. Swag. Do this. this could be fixed a little bit. I wish I could tell what I sketched better here. What am I looking at? That's obviously a rib cage. That's an arrow. I think this is an arm. I think maybe this is like a head, kind of like tilted back into the water, maybe. Okay, I'm thinking we do something like this, fix this up. Struggle with drawing skeletons. For anyone who's seen my my other Vulture of Lurook art, the Dungeons of Lurook post, the first one of which I posted, I had a similar situation with the skull, kind of you could see the top of his head, and it was such a weird angle to draw. Cause I don't really even want you to be able to see this face right now. This is like the under jaw. Ooh, this is gonna be a difficult one. What if we do something like that? Maybe. Draw like that. Oh yeah, that looks pretty good actually. And then I might just need to kind of draw like the edges of the facial features. So this would be like the nose. It'd be like something like that, but obviously you wouldn't really see the eyes. Maybe like small tiny bit of the eyes. Like I just drew just drew the exact same thing twice. Maybe kinda then kinda just shave that off. I feel like that looks alright, although probably could go more.